But then you left out the fact that really? The White House, and that's what it you know.
Bring some more light to the show, please.
You know he a Cowboys. Yeah,
so please tell us what you mean.
Yeah, hang out with the White House. They had to close the White House.
So the nickname of the house where they was getting high at was called the White House.
Yes, I don't know if they was getting high. I'm not saying that.
Yeah, sure, what they was doing.
It's called the White House.
No, JD, you're not just going to get it. So I just want to tell you thank you, JD, and I.
Welcome back to It Is What It Is. This episode is sponsored by Underdog Fantasy. Fab is an easy way to make some cash just by making picks with your favorite players. Underdog is available in more than 30 states, including California, Florida, Texas, and New York, just to name a few. Make sure to support the show by hitting the link in the bio and downloading the Underdog Fantasy app. They will also match your first deposit up to $100, and you get a special pick when you sign up. I'm Treasure Wilson, a.k.a. Stat Baby, along with your host, soon-to-be Mace, and Cam.
What's going on, Stat? What's happening?
I'm good. How are you?
I can't complain, man. We got some people in the building today.
Yeah, we got a lot of people in the building today, so it's going to be a good episode. Today, we are joined in studio with Nelly, Jermaine Dupree, and our analyst, Maurice Claret.
What's going on, man? It's a star. Yo, this is a star-studded event. Yo, we almost got the whole country in here. Nobody from the West Coast in here right now. We got the East Coast. We got the Midwest. We got the South. It's no, look, I just want to tell you guys, thank you so much for joining. Mo, what's up? I'm going to teach with you in 1 minute. I just want to tell you guys, thank you so much. For joining me, JD. I didn't even know you was coming, man.
No, he was with me, man. I just said I gotta go something.
No, I seen Rocco earlier with Nelly, and Rocco's always with JD since the very first time I ever met JD. And I was saying that how much I love, you know, we in New York, we be fighting, don't speak to each other for 15 years. And me and Mason got cool again a year and a half ago after not speaking for 15 years. And it's like, damn, man, when I see people together for so long, it really makes me happy, the unity and people sticking together. Nelly, you my man. Before we even get to anything with you and get to some sports, I want to say thank you to JD. I don't think I ever got a chance to thank him because he's on my first album with two different cuts, actually did a hook for me. And when I was young, I was real arrogant. Because my man Mace just sold 4 million records, and I'm thinking I'm supposed to sell 4 million records, and I don't think I ever gave JD his flowers for even doing what he did for me, because I may have been that thinking in my brain, well, May sold 4 million. I'm about to sell 4 million. And it just didn't work out like that. You know what I'm saying? So I just want to tell you, thank you, JD. And I really appreciate it. And I don't think I ever gave you some your flowers that you deserve, because I may have been arrogant. But I just want to tell you, it meant a lot to me that you did that for me, invited me to your house. And you didn't have to do that. So I just want to tell you, thank you in front of everybody, because I probably never even did it privately, let alone publicly. So I really salute you and tell you thank you. And thank you for coming through and still doing your fucking thing before me, after me. And Puff better watch his mouth on them fucking verses, nigga. I think we talk about shit dangerous with JD. Don't sleep on that nigga. Shit will get real dangerous, man. So just thank you, though. Seriously, I just want to thank you very much, man. I appreciate that.
Well, it's a pleasure to have both of you guys here. Maurice, how are you doing today as well?
Mosi! Hey. Cocaine Cowboys.
Uh-oh.
Oh, you got the Cocaine Cowboys shirt on.
Yeah, I see
them. Because you know what happened? I'm bringing y'all up to speed. So I said the last time the Cowboys won the Super Bowl, that a lot of... I said a lot of the players was on cocaine. So they may want to revisit that in 2024.
Oh.
So it may be the Cocaine Cowboys. So Mo went and got the shirt there. If the Jerry Jones...
Wow.
Y'all may want to look into this. The last time a Super Bowl was won was when y'all was on cocaine. Cowboys. Y'all may want to revisit that if you won another Super Bowl. Vote. Shirts is fire. Send my shit in. I can't wait.
Off and running.
Yeah, they want to send them shits to Dallas. Trust me, that's the last time they won. Shout out to Troy Aikman, Emmitt Smith, Michael Irvin, you my nigga.
That's my kid.
Yeah. But well, we all know what happened the last time that Super Bowl was down there in Dallas, man.
Yeah.
Shirts is fire, baby.
Bet you guys didn't expect to start the show with Cocaine Cowboys.
I actually heard y'all talk about that. You left out the fact that it's the White House. That's what it, you know.
They had
them. Oh, yeah. Had okay. Bring some more light to the show, please.
You know he a Cowboys.
So please tell us what you mean.
Yeah, the hangout was the White House. They had to close the White House.
So the nickname of the house where they was getting high at was called the White House?
Yes, I don't know if they was getting high. I'm not saying that.
We had said what they was doing.
It's called the White House.
No, JD, you're not just going to say the White House is like trying to move on. What do you mean?
The Cowboys hangout was called the White House.
In the 90s, you're saying?
Yeah,
for the
everybody know this. This ain't like nothing. This is a secret.
Okay, just because JD trying to brush over it. So sometimes we got viewers that's learning sports as we go along. Man. What JD is saying that the Cowboys that won the Super Bowls back in the 90s used to hang out in a house called the White House. JD is saying he doesn't know why it was called the White House. But why would it be called the White House in Dallas?
Big-ass White House, though, from what I was understanding.
Yeah.
The White House is in D.C.
It was a big White House.
Yeah. Okay, I'm just bringing the viewers up to speed.
It's in D.C.
Yeah, that's why I was wondering why a White House would be in Dallas, but, we know he's a Cowboy fan, so he has
more. Well, we heard they found some in that White House, too, not too long ago, so it's all good in D.C.
Yeah, that's a fact. Look, man, JD don't want to say it's prostitution going on. It was cocaine. Listen, I heard Michael Irvin is my man, but I heard Michael Irvin say out his own mouth, we was trying to do the wrong thing the right way. What's the wrong thing the right way? So where they went was the White House. So they could do all the wrong things right way.
We here now.
Yeah.
All the way. Right. All the way.
Welcome, baby. Welcome, right. Baby. That's how we do.
Okay, so let's get into the sports topics. Alabama head coach Nick Saban has retired. Mm. He has a record 7 national championships, 6 of them in Alabama, a record 15 straight seasons during which the team was ranked number 1 at some point, and a record 44 Alabama players picked in the first round of the NFL draft. But what do you think contributed to him calling it quits?
Mo, you go first, baby.
Yeah, I think the landscape has changed, man. You have more young kids, even black kids, I'll say it, who have more power. And I think everybody in the room has seen this, where you'll have black kids who become in power, who can think for themselves, who have resources, who have money. And I just think this is an era that he doesn't want to coach in. He doesn't want to deal with that. That dynamic has never been a part of him coaching, recruiting. He's never had to recruit against somebody like Prime. He's never had to recruit in the social media era. And I think when you look at what happened with Dabo Sweeney, I think he kind of looking like, man, I'm 70 years old. You know, he owns a bunch of Mercedes Benz dealerships and Ferrari dealerships. And I think he's like, look, man, this is my last run. I don't want to be involved in this stuff. I don't want to be around these kids. He's a good guy. I love a lot of his material, but I just think he just realized that the game that he once knew isn't here anymore. And he just wants to move on.
One time in the top?
Yeah.
God damn, T, what the, turn that shit off. Turn the Bluetooth off so you don't make that mistake.
Look,
again.
I like, is the belt marching band doing this?
Nick Saban threw a grenade in.
Damn, Nick. No, to his point, I first of all, let me say that, you know, Nick is one of the GOATs when it comes to coaching. I mean, his stats is unmatched. It's unprecedented what he was able to do in college football. But I think he hit it on the head. I think it's very, very convenient at this point in time when you talk about dealing with NIL, you're talking about dealing with the portal, you're talking about people being able to, you just don't have to go to Alabama now to be seen, so to speak, or have to go to some of these big colleges to be seen. I mean, and I think it's very, very convenient. Now, that doesn't mean that he's not genuine when he says that he's done. I just think the timing was hella convenient at this point. Like, yo, you know what? Like Mauricio said, you know, I don't want to have to deal with somebody like Prime or any of these young coaches that are coming in that's on a different level right now, because definitely because of the social era. Everybody want to be seen, so.
Want to chime in, Jay? Hold on, let Jay know. Let's go around the board.
What is that?
Go ahead, Mo.
Yeah, go ahead.
I didn't know he was going to go, but it's to the point where Prime came in, and they try to minimize and try to make it into a circus. That's what they want to market it as.
Right.
But he showed you I can cut through all this history, and there's a lot of former players who want to exist in that same environment. And Saban is smart. He's like, man, if Prime can come and cut through all of what I've built over my history, and he can get the same recruits, and he can go raise the same money, and he can go solicit the same kids who come out the hood of St. Louis, Atlanta, New York, wherever these dudes come from, that's a contributing factor to your whole business model. And so I think that has to be looked at, because I'm pretty sure there's a lot of college coaches that feel that way. That it's just, I don't know, it's a new era. My fault. I don't want to take up all the time.
Nah, go ahead. It's all good.
Yeah. I thought the Falcons coach got cut, right? So then, you know, Arthur Blank had hollered at them and told, dude, come to Atlanta. That's what I think.
So you think he going to the NFL?
Yeah.
You Nick Saban?
Yeah.
I'll say this, like when Moses said Nelly, Maurice, I call him Nelly Moses, just so we do the same thing. And we got more on the screen. They're absolutely right. He had an outstanding career. Legacy is undeniable as far as college football is concerned. But get the fuck out of here, nigga. You can't keep up with Prime. You was hating on Prime in the fucking beginning. Prime started doing his thing. Then you want to do commercials with Prime. A lot of niggas was like, we've been on Nick Saban ass this whole season.
Right.
So niggas was like, Kerry, y'all ran him out. Gotta take the credit. Because you can't, look, I take it as you, like, Maurice made a great point. You can't keep up what's going on with NIL, so you rather quit. I'm not even going to sit here and say all this nice shit they said. You can't even keep up. Damn, I can't control niggas no more. That's what it basically boils down to.
And it stops becoming about Alabama. When you go to Alabama, you know you're going to an institution. You're going to Alabama. Nick Saban is the biggest name in Alabama. Now, with Prime, it is different, but he at least allows his players to shine. Now, with NIL, if you're a superstar player and you know you go to Alabama, you won't be bigger than Alabama. But if you go to a different school and you can shine, that's more money for you in your pocket.
The whole NIL situation. But this is what I'm saying, Nelly, is that NIL just came into play. Before that, you're like, if I go to Alabama, LSU is a better chance I'm going to the NFL.
Mm-hmm.
And you're not making any money. So your thing is to go to Alabama so you could get to the money.
Right.
Niggas is getting to the money now.
Exactly. That's what I'm saying.
Yeah, exactly. So we're agreeing with each other. And now that niggas is getting to the money, it's like when Travis in Colorado, when Deion got him, Nick was accusing the niggas giving him $1 million before he got there. Deion and Travis was like, what the fuck are you talking about? Nobody gave me $1 million. Oh, my bad. I didn't mean it if you didn't give it to him. Nick, bye. Go to NFL. JD got the inside scoop. Go to Atlanta.
That's my thought.
That's
that's your thought?
Okay, yeah.
That's
yeah. Anyway, we can't see you get the wait to get out of here because you can't keep up with niggas, and now you mad. I call that some sucker shit because you quit 2 or 3 years in the NIL instead of trying to figure it out and say, how can I manipulate the situation? It was a recruit that was talking. I don't know the recruit's name. And he was saying it wasn't Nick Saban, but he was telling another coach. I wasn't sure if it was Oregon. I believe it was Oregon coach. Or I don't want to say the wrong coach. Mo probably talking about Maurice. And he said, no, I think I'm going to go to Colorado. And they said, what the fuck, you want to be a rapper? Niggas like,
damn.
Yeah, that type shit. Sheesh. You know what I'm saying? You know what it is,
why
Mo?
You wouldn't want to go play for
the lineman.
Go ahead.
You know what I'm talking about. Right.
Yeah, the lineman from Colorado, they were trying to solicit him away from Colorado. And basically what they said was that, you know, like this is what I'm talking about. They were saying you want to be a rapper. That's the only reason that you would want to go to Dion, and they try to make him theatrical as if he wasn't a Hall of Fame player and had a school career.
Yo.
And so what they do is when it comes to, like, so basically Nick Saban can't control niggas anymore. And he don't want to compete against niggas. And that's, you kind of open the door with this one up, but that's all it is. And all of these coaches, they'll attack, like, the character or things that loosely, that they feel represent black people or, like, niggas. And say, hey, man, you want to sit in a rapper bucket, or it's like the only way you're going up there is to be entertained. And so, I don't know, you look at it, you shake your head, like you can give his props to say who he was, but you shake your head, and like you say, he runs from this new environment. You know, he got beat by Harbaugh, so the SEC isn't the dominant figure anymore, or the dominant figure in college football anymore, and it's just a new day, you know, so I'm happy though.
And real quick, just to the NIL point, it's like with Marvin Harrison Jr., you know, he could go to the NFL now. Ohio State is offering him, and you know, the reports are super duper high. Mo, we was talking about it maybe 2 weeks ago, but it was a headline that they're offering $25 million to stay for one more year. Mo was saying it'd be more regular, around $6 or $7, $8 million if he stayed. When he would make in the NFL. So let me ask you this. I ask you the question. If you're in college right now, Nelly, and you can go to NFL next year and you're going to make $10 million. But Ohio State or whatever school you're at said, stay one more year because you have another year eligibility, and we'll give you the same $10 million that the NFL will give you. What would you do in that scenario?
You know what? That's a tough one in a sense, but I probably would lean more towards staying one more year, but depending on how my contract reads, because if I stay one more year, am I going to be insured? What happens if I get hurt?
Right.
And something happens that I can't get to the NFL. If I get to the NFL, you know what I'm saying? I don't know, like, how the pension shit work or whatever the case may be, but if
you
I get
no pension in 1 year.
Well, that's my point.
Right.
So if I go to the NFL, I probably would stay. I probably would stay because if I can, long as I can stay healthy, then that's $20 million in 2 years.
See, that's the thing. I would stay too because you get the same injury that you're worried about. You can catch the same injury in the NFL, and I think the injury risk is higher playing with grown men.
Well, and there's more games. It's way more grueling than college. You know what I mean? NFL games is real life, man. I saw Ray Lewis hit Marshall Faulk one time, and I swear to God, boy, I was like...
listen, homeboy Warner from St. Louis, when the Rams was in St. Louis, what's this nigga Warner?
Kurt Warner.
Nigga knocked him out of his career. Career got knocked out. He said, they knocked his old ass out of his retirement. They said, sit your ass down. He said, I'm good. I'm good. I had a great career. Real quick, Beffa, are you here? Your friends is here.
Beffa,
your crew is here, man.
Check it.
What the fuck you got on your head, Beffa? Murder. He frozen?
Yo,
JD is here. JD is here. Maurice Porret and Nelly is here.
It's a great shot.
Oh, you need that picture. Take a picture of that screen.
Your Wi-Fi is whack.
It's the hat, man.
To me right there.
Yo, Mo, yo, Murder, you gotta fix your Wi-Fi, B. Your shit, you got that Australian Wi-Fi. That shit ain't coming through right for us.
You
If that's what we're doing, let me know. And get petty up here.
Oh, God.
Welcome back. Welcome back. You left me yesterday with no. I handled the show by myself. It was cool. Listen, hold on now. Murder, your Wi-Fi is trippy, and you got what the fuck you got on your wrist?
Man, that's what's fucking the Wi-Fi up.
What's on your head?
All the
signal.
Yep. Juicy.
Yeah.
This that been around the world. This got Nelly tickets. It got
Silver
Soul Dev tickets on it. It got DMX tickets on it.
Oh, yeah. All right, cool, man.
Okay.
You need a stronger Wi-Fi signal, man. But we back. We gonna get ready to move on so you can jump right in. Pause. Well, since everybody's on point today, pause. Nelly wants to play, pause, so he's in. He's in,
nah,
pause.
I'm hearing what I'm hearing. You know what I mean?
No, you watch the show, and you got a Harlem pass, too. You really, you got some Harlem shit with you, too, man.
Yeah, man, I've been up there before.
Yeah.
And then real quick to the Nick Saban point. I mean, he is 72 years old, and he mm-hmm. did say that his age was making it a lot harder for him to compete. Mm-hmm. And then just with the climate, kind of like what you guys said, there's a lot going on for head coaches. So I just don't think that he can compete with what other coaches got going on right now. But I will say, for whoever's going to fill his shoes, I would not want that job right now, because it's going to be hard to bring Alabama and keep him at a consistent power point. But we'll see what happens.
It's still a great school.
Yeah, it is. Definitely. Okay, moving along, there's a lot of coaches who are leaving. Bill Belichick and the Patriots have parted ways after 24 seasons. He was the highest paid NFL coach, gaining around $25 million annually. But this year, the Patriots had a 4-13 record. So was it time for Belichick to leave?
4-13 for 25 mil? That was financial. I think he might be in the same boat as Nick to a certain degree, Nick Saban, and to a certain degree in a sense of, I think once Tom left, I think I'm trying to watch myself around these parts.
Be careful. Be careful.
I think a lot of his skeletons was coming out the closet, so to speak, in the theory of the way him and Tom complimented each other as far as working together on the field. Did I say that right?
That was so old.
We ain't gonna be out. You winning right now, so you don't want to catch more. Pause. Go ahead, Mo. Maurice.
No, I say it's the same thing. Like, you know, sports and music is almost the same thing, right? Where you have people who you catch lightning in the bottle with. You know, he had Tom for all those years, and you had all those amazing defenses. You know, he had Josh McDaniels as his offensive coordinator, and you just build like magic with people inside of these moments, and then. When your people start to leave, you think you can recreate the same thing, and I think he's starting to realize, like, man, I don't have it. I don't have the patience probably to rebuild a quarterback and go on that same run that I went on with Tom. And so I just think he's gracefully bowing out, realizing that sometimes you just have moments where you have I just can name it a music thing, the right producers, the right studios, the right people, the right everything. It's the same thing with this show. This show is the same thing as the Patriots. You catch
the
light.
No, the fuck we not. What Patriots you talking about? 2001? You gotta be talking about the 2001, 2003 Patriots. That's the 2024 Patriots, nigga.
But truth be told, he may not be done, though. He may not be done.
He said he's not done.
He may go somewhere else. I just think that time has ran out in New England.
He said he's not finished coaching. God, I ain't want to cut you off, but don't ever compare to the 2024 Patriots, nigga. Fuck you talking about? I just want to be clear on that.
Yeah,
no, but you know what I'm talking about. I'm talking about
I don't know what you're talking about.
Yeah, you know, the golden years of that.
We don't know, Maurice.
We don't know. There go my nigga. They ain't back now. Yeah, there you go. Murder. We're talking about the niggas is is 4-13, and then they say, yeah, this show is like The Patriot. What the fuck is that talking? What is he talking about, Murder?
Yeah, what is Nelly talking about? That nigga ain't gotta go home, but he gotta get out of here.
No, Maurice Claret said that.
No, I didn't say that, Jeff. I think that hat too tight. That was the other mo, cuz. You know what I'm saying?
Yo, Nelly, that was crazy. The hat too tight is crazy.
Really?
For that.
Yeah, you might have to go to court. Like, what is the ball cap?
Yo,
no, go ahead.
Ball cap.
That might have been it.
Yo, Murder, what are you
That might have been it.
I don't even gonna say that.
Yeah, that was $1.
Yo, Murder, what you think about Bill Belichick retiring? You think you had something to do with that?
I think I pause. I walked him out. You know, I'm an expert like that, Killer. When I talk about something, it happens. So I'm glad they got the cold cam. You working that.
Yeah.
I'm going to help you go to the Super Bowl right now.
All
right. By letting you know who's going to win the championship before it ever happens. Nobody on that desk can say this. Only I can say this.
Here we go.
Nobody else can say this, Cam.
Who's going to win, Murder? Who's going to win, Murder? The reason I'm saying this is because you said about 3 weeks ago Bill Belichick may not be there at the end of the season. I'm trying to give you your props and you don't even want to accept them. If you want to give us your prediction for the Super Bowl, we're here to listen. We're trying to work with you because you're on such a delay.
Not right now. I can't do it right now.
JD, you got what you think about Bill leaving?
Everything is coming to Atlanta. You know what I mean?
Bill and Nick Saban together.
I'm just saying, you know.
This
nigga, yo, I've never seen a more Atlanta nigga in my life. This nigga is the most Atlanta.
We got an issue.
I tell him all the time, Atlanta, only baseball and soccer. That's the only championships they winning. They will never win basketball and football. They got good players and good teams, but let me tell you what happens. There's too many brothers on them teams. See, when Atlanta wins, Atlanta turns up. And every step Atlanta gets closer to a championship, they turn up even more. And just like, remember when they was up at halftime? All of them, JD, everybody went live at halftime. It's on fire. It's going up. We about to kick it.
Yeah.
Boy, that did not age well. It wasn't even 2 hours later. Yeah. You could have dropped a pin in Atlanta and heard that thing drop.
Yeah, I'm not going to lie. That was one of the worst second halves I've ever seen in my life, man. I forgot about that, actually. Because that's when, and look, that brings it back to Tom Brady and Bill Belichick. Bill Belichick and Tom Brady, I'll just say this. Tom Brady won. When it comes to the battle of Tom Brady and Bill Belichick, it never was right when Tom Brady got hurt. Jimmy Garoppolo came in. Jimmy Garoppolo did a good job. Bill Belichick wanted to replace Tom Brady with Jimmy Garoppolo. I'm gonna let you go in a minute. Nelly, I'll let you go.
That first Super Bowl was
Nelly, how you going? I let everybody go,
Super Bowl is
Nelly, it doesn't go like that. I'll let you go, man. Again. It goes around, and then it's my go, and then if you want to go again, you can go. I let you go first, and then you just want to cut me off 35 seconds into my shit. What's fraudulent? Okay, let's argue about it. What's fraudulent?
That first Super Bowl was fraudulent.
What first Super Bowl?
They beat the Rams. And that's when Spygate, your man Bill Belichick, was cheating. They was taping our play. They was taping our practices.
What does this have to do with Jimmy Garoppolo?
Because it's never about the quarterback at the end of the day with Tom Brady or Bill Belichick. I'm just saying it's fraudulent.
You sound like you're emotional over some territorial shit because it was the St. Louis Rams at the time before they went to L.A.
Right,
anyway, like I was going to say, I don't even know what the fuck Jimmy Garoppolo had to do with any of that. Bill Belichick wanted to replace Tom Brady with Jimmy Garoppolo. Tom Brady, when he came back from injury, didn't have it. Went to Robert Kraft, went over Bill Belichick's head and said, get Jimmy Garoppolo the fuck out of here. It's been turmoil ever since then. And then when Tom Brady left, everybody's like, oh, who's going to win, Bill Belichick or Tom Brady? Bill Belichick or Tom Brady? Tom Brady goes to Tampa. Tom Brady ends up getting the Super Bowl the very first year that he leaves the Patriots. Bill Belichick hasn't been able to recover since. He got Cam Newton. Cam Newton caught COVID. He ended up with Mac Jones. Mac Jones seemed like he should still be in college because he hasn't done shit in the NFL yet. And Bill Belichick is like, I can't really do anything with this. Robert Kraft is like, look, we're a historic organization. We have a reputation to keep. I don't know if we're going to get it with you. Pause. It looks like they may need to rebuild. And if they do rebuild, Bill Belichick is way too old to be rebuilding. He's 72 years old. It's about to be 72 years old. So, yeah, JD.
I was talking about this earlier, right? And Bow said that he think that he going to the Raiders, and because Tom Brady is part owner of the Raiders.
Right. You talking about Bill Belichick?
Yeah.
Well, listen, the thing about it is, I just want to get to kind of where we were at real quick. And Bill Belichick, like I said, he's too old to rebuild. I think he had a historic career. The Patriots was my team, and I'm from New York. A very long time, so
you don't think he's gonna coach no more at all?
No, he said he's gonna coach. I was watching all day yesterday, and Bill Belichick said he's not finished coaching. Mm-hmm. He says he's coming back to coach. It's just not gonna be with the Patriots. And even at the speech yesterday, I watched the whole speech with him and Robert Kraft, and Robert Kraft was saying, I'm gonna be rooting for Bill Belichick along the way no matter what, except when he plays against the Patriots. So they both kind of indicated that he'll be coming back. I just don't think that the Patriots are going to win anything. And he's saying, look, Bill Belichick, and God bless, if he lived to be 150, but let's be serious, maybe 20 years, God willing, and he still wants to coach. He needs to get somewhere to go and win in the next 5-6 years, possibly.
Let me ask you this.
Yeah, you want to talk about the Rams now?
Fraudulent.
No, definitely fraudulent. No, but I think that they both had a good chemistry, like you said again. But Tom Brady, actually, in those first couple Super Bowls, he didn't play that well. You know what I'm saying? That first Super Bowl, he didn't play good at all, actually, those defenses. And I think that that's probably what set Bill in the spiral of him thinking that, you know what I'm saying, defense does win championships, but just thinking he can plug a quarterback in that position to play.
That's a nigga out the side of the window like Flavor Flav. He's bugging me out, yo.
Might have been Flav.
That's the crazy part about this. He talking, I'm watching this nigga do Flavor Flav shit,
all
yo.
Day.
All day. All the time.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. He's doing the Flavor. I don't know what he's doing.
Yeah, all day.
My bad, man.
Gang banging on bed.
But see, the thing about it, Mo, and you're right, is that Bill Belichick is a defensive coach. He was a defensive coach with the Giants. That's why he loves Lawrence Taylor so much. That's his favorite player. Then he went to the Browns. He's a defensive-minded coach. And what they were talking about in the press conference today as well is that, you know, they were saying that he's also the general manager, not just the coach.
He's picking the players.
Right. So they're saying that he didn't have that job. He earned that job with Robert Kraft. The first 3 years, he wasn't general manager. Robert Kraft said he earned that cachet with him to make him general manager. But obviously, that's not working out. You're picking the food, cooking the groceries, picking out the groceries, cooking them isn't working out. And I think it was mutual. They said it's mutual, but it's like, look, I got 5-6 years to get something done. Rob, I love you, but it ain't going to happen. And Rob's like, yo, you served your time here. You won me 6 championships. You took us to 8 and 9. I think it was great, and I think they had a great run. So salute to Bill Belichick, but it was no indication that he's not going to coach anymore. JD says he has some inside information that he's coming to the Raiders. JD got a lot of shit going on. Nick Saban is going to Atlanta, and Bill Belichick is going to Vegas because Tom Brady has something to do with the Raiders. This is JD. Let's keep an eye on this for next season because we may come back and get to the videotape if you're right.
Bow gonna want credit for that, though.
I ain't say no more.
And then, Maurice, did you have another point about Belichick? Because I saw you.
No, when I heard Cam talking, I was wondering if Bill Belichick's ego wants to win another championship without Tom Brady, because a lot of people talk about he can't do it without Tom Brady, and Tom Brady went to the Bucks, and he did it without Bill Belichick.
Oh, definitely that's something to do with it, in my opinion. But at the same time, but you got to realize, Nick Saban, and I know we probably, I got to look at the topics. I know we probably going to get to Pete Carroll. And Nick Saban, Pete Carroll, and Bill Belichick are all over 70 years old. And they, nobody wants to just do this to do it. I'm pretty sure they want to win another championship before they die. I'm not saying they're about to die, but it's, you know, it's life. We're not stupid. But it's definitely ego involved. But what happens is this, too. When you've been doing this so long, you say, I'm going to go retire. And if you don't have a plan B, you sit home on the couch and you yell at your TV on Sundays. Or if you coach college, you yell at your TV on Saturdays. And you're like, your wife is like, why don't you go out and coach a high school team or something, nigga? Because you in here driving me crazy. This is what you've been doing the last 40, 50 years. And you never had, and you made enough money. So you're financially secure to where it isn't like you have to go out and do anything else. But if this is what you've been doing the last 40, 50 years, and you're not Nick Saban with 17 car dealerships, what do? That's the real question.
Okay. Well, I love that you brought up Pete Carroll, because we're going to talk about Pete Carroll. So he's also done in Seattle, but as head coach, he will now have an advisor role. He coached the team for 14 seasons and led the team to win two NFC championships and their only Super Bowl title in franchise history. So how do you feel about this decision? And then just in general, with all these coaches leaving, other than NIL and like other things, what do you think that they're dealing with now that they haven't dealt with years ago?
You know, the thing that's in common with all three of them, they all defense first coaches.
Okay, right.
They all of them is defense first. They think defense first. And if you look where the game is moving, whether it's in college or whether it's even in the pros, right. Now defense still wins championships, but you got to be able to put up some points.
Right.
In the league, period. And I think all three of them are warranted or a little stubborn in their ways, because they've all had success doing it their way.
Right.
And sometimes, like you were just explaining, it's hard to change.
Right.
Just overnight like that, to be like, yo, you know what? I'm going to think a little bit more offensive with what it is that I'm doing here. But when you've had success doing it your way, like you said, it's kind of like music. You go in and you got your method and your way of doing it, and you done got hits, and then you go in to work with somebody else, and they like, yo, try it like this. And you like, yo, talking to this is how I do it,
right.
But now it's not working like that, and I think they got to let a little bit of that ego go and start conforming a little bit more.
Right. What you got, Mo? And Murder?
I just, for whatever reason, when he said it, he's passing the baton. I don't know why, when I look at Pete Carroll, he looks, he comes off more like a player's coach, and then him just ascending to a different level. It looks like, hey, I'm getting out the way. My run is done. Let somebody else have the spot that I'm in.
My name is Dana Belfi, and my husband and I own the Village Bakery located in Hayden, Idaho. TikTok has helped me become an advocate for those with different abilities. It's allowing us to show what acceptance looks like here at the bakery.
Tax liens are very simple. See, every county charges property taxes, which means some property owners don't pay their taxes. So we go to the county and we give them the taxes that are owed by that property. And we're making a deal directly with the county. We're not making a deal with the homeowner. And the county secures our money through a tax lien onto that property. And in some cases, with a mandated return as high as 25%.
You that we have a phenomenal guest to kick off season 3 of Street You Grew Up On. That is definitely a this woman is an award-winning
actor. She's a both you guys. I think that Pete Carroll is definitely a player's coach. Like, when I watch Pete Carroll on the sidelines, I'm like, yo, if I play football, I want to play for that guy. He's not the Nick Saban. And them guys look great for their age as well, but he's not the Nick Saban, Bill Belichick.
And only Kelly Rowland.
You look amazing.
You look amazing.
You look so good.
And Kelly Green.
Thank you.
Hello, hello.
Thank you for doing this.
I am so excited to be doing this. You got me on a really interesting day.
Tell me.
It was just one spiritual experience after another this morning. It was so dope. And my son came in, and
I started like having this moment where I just couldn't help but to praise. And so he comes in and he's like doing this. He sees me do this and yes. I'm like still curling my hair yes, and everything. Yes. And then he starts to join in with me. I said, oh my God, I know this is everything my mother prayed for. Was for it to be like from her generation to my generation to his generation to see me giving God glory. And I was like so happy. I just cried, boo-hooed, and I was like, it is no wonder we're having this conversation this morning.
Wow.
How everything happened. So this has already blessed my day. So thank you.
Thank you. Thank you for sharing that. Sure.
It's just the sweetest moments. Sweetest
okay, moments so tell us what is the street you grew up on.
Okay.
And like what city, what state. And then usually I ask, I don't know, because you've had a praise-filled morning. So usually I either ask you to tell me the street you grew up on by telling me your superhero name or yes. your porn name. I don't know if you can put a porn name after all that God talk.
Mine is it's definitely a porn name.
Tell me.
It was Mocha Boulevard.
Oh my goodness.
Mocha Boulevard.
That's your best.
I know, right?
Mocha Boulevard. You might need a jacket that says Mocha. That's like a brand for you, Mocha Boulevard.
That's a great idea.
Yeah. Tell me about the
pets. So Mocha didn't come till later.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I was able to get my own pet or four.
Oh, it wasn't when you were on the boulevard.
No.
Okay.
I didn't have a pet. They didn't allow pets there.
Nope. She wasn't my pet, but I fed her. It was my grandma's dog. You ready for this?
Yes.
Chi Chi Boulevard.
Chi Chi's even better.
Well, they're sort of like, if you're gonna brand, there's two sides of the court. Mocha's like a little more elegant and grown up. Chi Chi Boulevard.
Chi Chi Boulevard.
They're both great.
Yeah, I really love them.
Okay, so what was the name of the street that you grew up on?
Boulevard.
It was called Boulevard. Now it's like called the Boulevard Boulevard? Like yes. It just was the Boulevard.
Grandma's Boulevard.
Wow.
Yeah. Okay, it was in Atlanta, Georgia.
Okay.
And it was 2840 Boulevard Drive. And I'll never forget it. It was a beautiful porch before you walked in the house. It was all these rocking chairs in the front with plants.
For all the great aunts, did they sit out there on the
yes,
porch?
Yes, they sat out there, watched everything that was going on in the neighborhood. You know such and such a son came in at this time.
Yes,
so it
yes.
was that.
Yeah. Did you have a seat on the porch too?
I did. They bought me my own red rocking chair. It's one of my favorite memories as a kid is being able to rock with them and sit out there with them. And it was something so peaceful and simple about that. And I'm really grateful to have them in my life so early because it's the simple things that they showed me. You know what I mean? From sitting outside to having a simple breakfast to this day, I'll drink my little lemon or lime water in the morning. Yeah, it was really awesome. Yeah.
So who was in the house? How many rooms were in the house?
It wasn't many rooms, but it was two rooms, and it's like this extra little back room.
They have a nice size house.
Yeah. One, two, three.
Two floors?
Yeah, two floors. Mm-hmm. One floor, but they made the attic a floor for my Aunt Janie Mae. And she had her own space upstairs because she was just that kind of girl.
She needed her own space.
She needed her own space.
So did everybody else share rooms? Did
yes.
you have your own room? Did you share a room with your mom?
I shared a room with my mom and because she had two twin beds.
Okay.
So my mom and I shared a bed. And it was so nice because I remember listening to a choir and waking up and seeing that and seeing the light reflect off of the yellow drapes. And the smell was butter and toast.
Always.
Butter and toast.
That's what was always happening. Is that what you had every morning for breakfast?
Pretty much toast, eggs.
I also think of that with like, were they all drinking their tea with toast? That's sort
yes.
of like an older lady's.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
Did your mom do the cooking? Did you cook? Did one of the aunties
My
cook?
My great aunts cooked. I remember, now this is real, real interesting to say.
Okay.
Like we had sausage. And one of them would have an oatmeal cookie and then a slice of cheese over the oatmeal cookie. It was government cheese and it was bomb.
Yes, it was.
It was so bomb.
Wait, cheese on the oatmeal cookie.
I know, it's strange, ain't it?
But, you know, I used to have jelly and cheese sandwiches.
That's
is
good.
Is that kind of, like, sweet and
yes.
salty
yes,
thing?
Yes, it is.
Was there a lot of music all day long? Was it just in the morning when you talked about waking up to the choir?
It was the morning. They'd have it playing, like, when we got in the car.
All the time.
All the time.
And always praise music.
Always praise yeah. music.
Was there a thing against secular music in the house?
I didn't necessarily feel that, but I did like Babyface.
Yeah, who didn't?
Exactly.
Yes.
and pebbles. And I remember listening to that, and my mama was like, all right, baby, that's enough.
we've had enough.
Yeah, but it was awesome.
Who else was in the house?
My great aunt.
Was your brother?
My brother wasn't in the house.
Okay.
He was old enough to be at the house by that time.
So it was all women.
All women.
Oh.
Yeah.
Did you share a closet with your mom? Did you? What was the room like that you shared? Did
we
it have
had
all
a dresser.
Stuff?
I had my little dresser with all of my stuff in it. Because before, like, I say their house because it was a place of stability for me. Because before that, my mom had a really rough time earlier. And we were kind of like place to place a bit.
Yeah. Do you remember that? Mm-mm. No.
I don't even remember that, but I remember my aunt's house as early as 5, maybe. As early as 5. Which is really crazy for me because I, like, from just different things that have happened in my life, a lot of my memories are, like, gone.
Yeah.
Well, so wild.
I think our brains protect us.
I do too.
Mm-hmm.
The body keeps the score.
Yes, truly.
Uh-huh.
Were there other kids on the street? Did you have other kids to play with?
Yes. My mom's best friend lived down the street. The
on Drayton's, Boulevard?
They lived on Oak Ridge. Oak Ridge Avenue, 69 Oak Ridge Avenue.
Hey!
And Amber Drayton. Was my as early as I can remember the most gorgeous, deeply chocolate, gorgeous smile girl you've ever seen in your life. I've never seen a girl so beautiful.
Coming from you.
Oh my gosh, she was so beautiful. And so we were
did
just
you
two
feel
chocolate
beautiful
girls
as a little girl? When you looked at her, did you think we're two beautiful little girls? Or was she beautiful?
I thought she was just so deep in chocolate. I just thought she was just an extra layer of beautiful, to be honest. I don't even think about that. Did I? I thought I was cute.
You did.
I thought I was cute.
Yeah, good.
Yeah.
Did the aunties pour that into you? Did your mom tell you you were beautiful?
My mom poured that into me, being the apple of her eye, my sugar pie, all of that.
What was it like on the holidays? Like, what were holidays like in your house?
Warm. They're some of the sweetest memories I think I have of me and my mother.
Mm. Any holiday in particular? Were you an Easter family or a Christmas family?
Christmas.
Yeah.
Christmas is good. Oh, Christmas. I'm usually, like, super happy and then super sad for Christmas.
Why?
Because of the fact, one, I can share this new generation with my kids, like, Christmas and warmth and this and that, because I go ham for Christmas.
You go crazy.
I do. I go crazy. Lights, I mean, all over the house, like, the whole house is adorned with Christmas.
Amazing.
Like, I go crazy.
Okay.
But Christmas at my aunt's house was amazing.
Tell me.
Everybody would come over. They would cook days before.
Jeez.
I mean,
did you help with the cooking?
I did help with the cooking.
Did you learn to cook from those?
I didn't pay attention as much as I should have, because the way these women made cakes and the smells and the greens and the, oh my gosh,
so
it's a hug. You know what I mean?
What was the main dish? Was it
ham?
Ham.
Girl, that ham.
Was it a pineapple?
It was pineapples and cherries.
Cherries?
Yes, it was pineapples and cherries.
Wow, we were a pineapple close family, but cherries was like what the fancy people did in the magazine. Like the bright red maraschino cherries?
Yes. Oh, and my Aunt Leanne's favorite color was red. So it was like anywhere there was red in the house, you know, she had some sort of hand in it.
I love it. Did you have a garden at that house?
No, but when we were there, like, there was all this land that my aunt had in the back. And we would just go out there, just poison ivy, just go back, just going on adventures. That wasn't a time where we could do that.
Right. You could
know
just
what I
be
mean?
Out in the
yeah,
wild.
Yeah, we had sticks guarding us and, like, moving leaves and stuff out of the way, and we were having wild adventures. Like, I wish my kids could do that.
Yeah.
I really, really do. Or maybe we just got to create the somewhat of that world or something.
I try to do that when we travel, like, go places where they can have a little bit more agency and not be hovering.
Yeah.
Because it's really important what you learn when you're out just exploring the world.
And figuring things out.
Yeah. Was there a time when you felt like you needed to have your own room when you were with your mom?
I didn't even think about it like that.
It wasn't an option.
Yeah, it wasn't an option. I didn't even think about it.
Yeah.
And,
I think that when I did have my own space, or when I first got my own space, it was with another friend of my mom. She allowed us to stay with her, but I shared a room with her daughter. So as early as I can remember, I was sharing a space, but it was still like a space that we just had on our own. And it was awesome because we would sit up there and talk at night, and it was great.
It's so funny because when I think of you, I think of you as somebody who really embraces your sisters.
Uh-huh.
Like, you're such a woman's woman.
I am.
And you're so generous with other women. And you're not one of these girls who's afraid to connect with other women. I know, and I love that about you. I love that about you. And so it's really beautiful to see where that comes from, that it comes from this generation of aunties and with your mom, that it actually wasn't like a sister, but that you've created sisterhood wherever you go.
Yeah. When I am in a friendship and it just feels surface, I'll ask why.
Do you really?
I do. I'll just say, you know, you've been distant. Why are you distant? Are you okay? Do you need to talk? But back to why are you distant? And I'll say, maybe that's what you need at this time. And I respect that. I understand that. Then I'll move back. But I'm concerned.
Yeah. I love hearing about the beginnings of where people's stories start, because we think we know, you know, you know, we look at your career and we say, like, oh, we know where the sisterhood girl thing started. And to know that, like, you know, you were primed for that. You were built for that before going into that environment in your performing life. It's so special.
But just talking to you about it now, I even just had an aha moment. I didn't even put two and two together at all.
Yeah.
And yes, I grew up in a space with all these women.
Do you feel like they're with you now? I feel like they're here
today. No, they're definitely here.
Yeah.
Everybody thinks I'm crazy. But I had a moment where when my dad told me my grandmother sang for Lena Horne and Count Basie.
No.
Yes.
Like, she sang, sang.
She sang. She sang, sang.
Like, professionally.
Like, wanted a career and everything. Had my dad, and, like, everything was just shifted a bit.
Wild.
So one day I was, what was I doing? Warming up or something. And I could feel every part of this woman. And I felt like she was saying, I'm living through you. Like, I'm living my dream through you. And I was just like, well, have at it.
You can't fit.
Give it up fast, quick and not slow. Not going to the tables if it's not about dough. So you know, Mom Deep is running this shit. QBC, nigga, rep your clip. Yo, son, I'm feeling it. Opposition want me dead, concealing shit from gas. Got me living, kid. Rushing through my pyramid, you secondary. Go against the grain, then you adversary. Had to bury niggas on my side that snitch. Ran his mouth like a bitch. Now he's laying in the ditch that he dug for himself. On his grave, I had to piss. Gut missile, never miss you. Hit you, scratch you off my lip. Gem star, rip through your mental. Deeper, you ain't having it, me neither. It's drama, ain't got time for no reapers. Rapanoid, make these niggas into believers.
What up, this cat right here, man? Word up.
The tough guy screwed me. I guess he got plans to ruin me. He wanted to do me. Slowly but surely, I peaked his fast ass a bit early. Grabbed him by his wig and shit was curly. Put the drone to his dome. Let him know it's never early. You can slide before I snatch the heat from his side. Saw the devil when despised by the look in his eyes. He was surprised. So I snatched him up. Regulated his gad and backed him up. Step to the side. Pete, blast him
up. Cannons are up. You got struck up for stroke sleep. So rapping nigga playing thug. Trying to post
you. Kill that nigga, man.
I remember was a shot for a stoji. You see big guns in 3D. Your strong team gets deep. Fucking with these Chinese. Taiwan burning my hip from high gas. Burning my lip from rose clips. Catch me on the 40th and bootlegger in the AM. These aren't take meridian cats, insomniacs. 4 in the morning, we throwing bats of cognac juice. Letting gas loose, the blue van blitz through. These fists too, couldn't find a pistol. Hey yo, hopped out the Lexus, holding my necklace. I'm bent on some neck shit. Gasoline wet, a kerosene twist, stumbling. Placing my gun right, it slipped down its caliber. Looking for chicks, they can stab now, numbed up. From a fiery cup of hell juice, it sends nectar. Saints found in you, mega action. Bitches all around, ready to fuck big asses. You all dog and shit, pressing your luck. My pipe games, like a night train. Top speed through your wound piece. Rated X to say the least.
Hey yo. The pussy fast,
but I'm fast, sure,
not slow. Not going to the tell if it ain't a free show. So you know, more than time of this shit. QBC, niggas rapping it clear. Give it up fast, quick and not slow. Not going to the tables if it's not about flow. So you know, more people's running this shit. QBC, niggas rapping it clear. And that's how I go.
And that's it, nigga. Word up. You know what I'm saying?
Don't go.
Rapping noise. Nas, Havoc, to the exit, niggas, we out, what up? It's over, baby. Tell the rest of the crew. Out the airport, the mom picked me up in the truck. Jerry Chunky like, fuck, I ain't scared to get stuck. So what's the deal, Poppy? You heard the feds almost got me. I had the Cuban posse all up in my room and lobby, negotiating like Illuminati network. We catch a body experts in retrospect to the foul connect when I lost. But that then was my fault. Now it's time to floss. Eye for eye, what's mine is yours. I need a suite with the flowers, complimentary at Trump Tower. Sit at the table, we could build for hours. I'm getting rich as a cinch, take a glimpse. The world is yours, written all over the blimps. Here's a toast to my foes, it's like a whole new beginning. With quaaludes and cream and loads of women rocking linen. I got a plan to blow to Hiroshima, Japan. Moving niggas out the hood and just divide it with fam. And yo, the bitches, like G-Money said to his man, I ride the dick like a horse with the cowboy brand.
Give it up fast, quick and not slow. Not going to the tables if it's not about gold. So you know, Mom Deep is running this shit. QBC, nigga, rep your clip.
Yo, son, I'm feeling it. Opposition want me dead, concealing shit from gas. Got me living, kid. Rushing through my pyramid, you secondary. Go against the green, then you adversary. Had to bury niggas on my side, that snitch. Ran his mouth like a bitch. Now he's laying in the ditch. Then he dug for himself. On his grave, I had to piss. Gut missile, never miss you. Hit you, scratch you off my lip. Gem star, rip through. Your mental, deeper. You ain't having it, me neither. It's drama, ain't got time for no reavers. Rapanoid, make these niggas into believers.
What up, this cat right here? Man, word up.
The tough guy screwed me. I guess he got plans to ruin me. He wanted to do me slowly but surely. I peaked his fast ass a bit early. Grabbed the vibes, waking shit was curly. Put the drone to his dome. Let him know it's never early. You can slide before I snatched the heat from his side. Saw the devil when despised by the look in his eyes. He was surprised. I snatched him up. Regulated his gad and backed him up. Step to the side. Pete blasted
him. Yeah, yo, cannons are up. You got struck up for stroke sleep. So rap a nigga playing thug. Trying to post. You
kill that nigga.
All I remember was a shot. Or Stoji. You see big guns in 3D, your small team gets deep. Fucking with these Chinese. Taiwan burning my hip from high gas. Burning my lip from rose clips. Catch me on the 40th and bootlegger in the AM. These aren't take meridian cats. Insomniacs. 4 in the morning, we throwing bats of cognac juice. Letting gas loose, the blue van blitz through. These fists too, couldn't find a pistol. Hey yo, hopped out the Lexus, holding my necklace. I'm bent on some neck shit. Gasoline wet, a kerosene twist, stumbling. Placing my gun right, it slipped down its caliber. Looking for chicks, they can stab now, numbed up. From a fiery cup of hell juice, it sends nectar. Saints found in you. Mega action, bitches all around, ready to fuck big asses. You all dog and shit, pressing your luck, my pipe games. Like a night train, top speed through your wound piece. Rated X to say the least. Get up the pussy fast,
get up fast,
quick and not slow. Not going to the tell if it ain't a free show. So you know, more than time of this shit. QBC, niggas rapping it clear. Give it up fast, quick and not slow. Not going to the tables if it's not about flow. So you know, more people's running this shit. QBC. City.
shit, niggas repping and clip. And that's how I go.
And that's it, nigga. Word up.
You know what I'm saying?
Don't go.
You know what
I'm saying? Rapanoid, rapping pig, Nas, have it. To the exit, niggas, we out. What up? So, baby.
The mom picked me up in the truck. Jerry Chunky like, fuck, I ain't scared to get stuck. So what's the deal, Poppy? You heard the feds almost got me. I had the Cuban posse all up in my room and lobby, negotiating like Illuminati network. We catch a body experts in retrospect to the foul connect when I lost. But that then was my fault. Now it's down the floors. Eye for an eye, what's mine is yours. I need a suite with the flowers, complimentary at Trump Tower. Sit at the table, we could build for hours. I'm getting rich as a cinch, take a glimpse. The world is yours, written all over the blimps. Here's a toast to my foes, it's like a whole new beginning. With quaaludes and cream and loads of women rocking linen. I got a plan to blow to Hiroshima, Japan. Moving niggas out the hood and just divide it with fam. And yo, the bitches like G-Money said to his man, about the dick like a horse with the cowboy brand.
Give it up fast, quick and not slow. Not going to the tables if it's not about dough. So you know, Mom Deep is running this shit. QBC, they can rep your clip.
Yo, son, I'm feeling it. Opposition want me dead, concealing shit from gas. Got me living, kid. Rushing through my pyramid, you secondary. Go against the grain, then you adversary. Had to bury niggas on my side, that snitch. Ran his mouth like a bitch. Now he's laying in the ditch. Then he dug for himself. On his grave, I had to piss. Gut missile. Never miss you. Hit you. Scratch you off my lip. Gem star ripped through. Your mental. Deeper. You ain't having it, me neither. It's drama. Ain't got time for no reavers. Rapanoid make these niggas into believers.
What up, this cat right here, man? Word up.
The tough guy screwed me. I guess he got plans to ruin me. He wanted to do me. Slowly but surely, I peaked his fast ass a bit early. Grabbed the bombs, waking shit was surely. Put the drone to his dome. Let him know it's never early. You can slide before I snatched the heat from his side. Saw the devil when despised by the look in his eyes. He was surprised. I snatched him up. Regulated his dad and backed him up. Step to the side. Pete, blast
yeah,
him
yo,
up.
Cannons are rough. He got struck up for stroke sleep. So rap a nigga playing thug, trying to post
you. Kill that nigga, man.
Remember was a shot for a stoji. You see big guns in 3D, your small team gets deep. Fucking with these Chinese. Taiwee burning my hip from high gas. Burning my lip from Bruce Clips. Catch me on the 40th and bootlegger. In the AM, these on take meridian cats. Insomniacs, 4 in the morning, we throwing bats of cognac juice. Letting gas loose, the blue van blitz through. These pissed too, couldn't find a pistol. Hey yo, I'm Dr. Lexus, holding my necklace. I'm bent on some neck shit. Gasoline with a kerosene twist, stumbling. Placing my gun right, it slipped down its caliber. Looking for chicks, they eat and stab now, numbed up. From a fiery cup of hell juice, it sends nectar. Saints found in you. Mega action, bitches all around, ready to fuck big asses. You all dog and shit, pressing your luck. My pipe games, like a night train. Top speed through your wound piece. Rated X to say the least. Get up the pussy fast,
get up fast,
quick and not slow. Not going to the tail if it ain't a free show. So like you know, more than time of this shit. QBC, yeah, we rapping and clip. Give it up fast, quick and not slow. Not going to the tables if it's not about dough. So you know, more deep is running this shit. QBC, niggas rapping and clip. And that's how I go.
And that's it, nigga. Word up. You know what I'm saying? Don't go. Rapanoid, rapping pig, Nas, have it. To the exit, niggas, we out. What up? So, baby.
Out the airport, the mall.
mom picked me up in the truck. Jerry Chunky like, fuck, I ain't scared to get stuck. So what's the deal, Poppy? You heard the feds almost got me. I had the Cuban posse all up in my room and lobby, negotiating like Illuminati network. We catch a body experts in retrospect to the foul connect when I lost. But that then was my fault. Now it's down the floors. Eye for eye, what's mine is yours. I need a suite with the flowers, complimentary at Trump Tower. Sit at the table, we could build for hours. I'm getting rich as a cinch, take a glimpse. The world is yours, written all over the blimps. Here's a toast to my foes, it's like a whole new beginning. With quaaludes and cream and loads of women rocking linen. I got a plan to blow to Hiroshima, Japan. Moving niggas out the hood and just divide it with fam. And yo, the bitches, like G-Money said to his man, I ride the dick like a horse with the cowboy brand.
Give it up fast, quick and not slow. Not going to the tables if it's not about dough. So you know, Mom Deep is running this shit. QBC, they can rep your clip. Yo, son, I'm feeling it. Opposition want me dead, concealing shit from gas. Got me living, kid. Rushing through my pyramid, you secondary. Go against the green, then you adversary. Had to bury niggas on my side, that snitch. Ran his mouth like a bitch. Now he's laying in the ditch. Then he dug for himself. On his grave, I had to piss. Gut missile, never miss you. Hit you, scratch you off my lip. Gem star, rip through. Your mental, deeper. You ain't having it, me neither. It's drama, ain't got time for no reavers. Rapanoid, make these niggas into believers.
What up, this cat right here, man? Word up.
The tough guy screwed me. I guess he got plans to ruin me. He wanted to do me. Slowly but surely, I peaked his fast ass a bit early. Grabbed the bottles, waking shit was curly. Put the drone to his dome. Let him know it's never early. You can slide before I snatched the heat from his side. Saw the devil in despise by the look in his eyes. He was surprised. I snatched him up. Regulated his gad and backed him up. Step to the side. Pete blasted
him. Yeah, yo, cannons are up. You got struck up for short sleep. So rapid nigga playing dubs, trying to post.
You kill that nigga, man.
I remember was a shot for a stoji. You see big guns in 3D, your small team gets deep. Fucking with these Chinese. Taiwan burning my hip from high gas. Burning my lip from rose clips. Catch me on the 40th and bootlegger. In the AM, these aren't take meridian cats. Insomniacs, 4 in the morning, we throwing bats of cognac juice. Letting gas loose, the blue van blitz through. These pissed too, couldn't find a pistol. Hey yo, I'm Dr. Lexus, holding my necklace. I'm bent on some neck shit. Gasoline with a kerosene twist, stumbling. Placing my gun right, it slipped down its caliber. Looking for chicks that he can stab now, numbed up. From a fiery cup of hell juice, a singed nectar. Saints found in you, mega action. Bitches all around, ready to fuck big asses. You all dog and shit, pressing your luck. My pipe game, like a night train. Top speed through your wound piece. Rated X to say the least.
Hey yo.
Get up fast,
get up fast, not slow. Not going to the cell if it ain't a free show. Yo, like you know, more than time of this shit. QBC, yeah, we rapping it lit. Give it up fast, quick and not slow. Not going to the tables if it's not about those. So you know, more people's running this shit. QBC, niggas repping it lit.
And that's how I go.
And that's it, nigga. Word up.
Show.
You know what I'm saying?
Don't go.
Don't go.
Chunky like, fuck, I ain't scared to get stuck. So what's the deal, Poppy? You heard the feds almost got me. I had the Cuban posse all up in my room and lobby. Negotiating like Illuminati network. We catch a body experts in retrospect to the foul connect when I lost. But that then was my fault. Now it's down the floors. Eye for eye, what's mine is yours. I need a suite with the flowers, complimentary at Trump Tower. Sit at the table, we could build for hours. I'm getting rich as a cinch, take a glimpse. The world is yours, written all over the blimps. Here's a toast to my foes, it's like a whole new beginning. With quaaludes and cream and loads of women rocking linen. I got a plan to blow to Hiroshima, Japan. Moving niggas out the hood and just divide it with fam. And yo, the bitches, like G-Money said to his man, I ride the dick like a horse with the cowboy brand.
Give it up fast, quick and not slow. Not going to the tables if it's not about dough. So you know, Mom Deep is running this shit. QBC, they can rep your clip.
Yo, son, I'm feeling it. Opposition
want me dead, concealing shit from gas, got me living, kid. Rushing through my pyramid, you secondary. Go against the grain, then you adversary. Had to bury niggas on my side, that snitch. Ran his mouth like a bitch, now he's laying in the ditch. Then he dug for himself, on his grave I had to piss. Gut missile, never miss you, hit you. Scratch you off my lip, gem star, rip through. Your mental, debunk, you ain't having it, me neither. It's drama, ain't got time for no reapers. Rapanoid, make these niggas into believers.
What up, this cat right here, man? Word up.
The tough guy screwed me. I guess he got plans to ruin me. He wanted to do me. Slowly but surely, I peaked his fast ass a bit early. Grabbed him by his wig and shit was curly. Put the drone to his dome. Let him know it's never early. You can slide before I snatch the heat from his side. Saw the devil when despised by the look in his eyes. He was surprised. I snatched him up. Regulated his gad and backed him up. Step to the side. Pete Black. Yeah, yo, cannons are rough. He got struck up for stroke sleep. So rapid nigga playing thug. Trying to post me.
Kill that nigga.
Oh, I remember was a shot for a stoji. You see big guns in 3D, your strong team is deep. Fucking with these Chinese. Tai Wee burning my hip from high gas. Burning my lip from rose clips. Catch me on the 40th and bootlegger. In the AM, these aren't take meridian cats. It's on the axe. 4 in the morning, we throwing bats of cognac juice. Letting gas loose, the blue van blitz through. These fists too, fucking find a pistol. Hey yo, I got the Lexus, holding my necklace. I'm bent on some neck shit. Gasoline with a kerosene twist, stumbling. Placing my gun right, it slipped down Excalibur. Looking for chicks, they can stab now, numbed up. From a fiery cup of hell juice, it sends nectar. Saints found in you. Mega action, bitches all around, ready to fuck big asses. You all dog and shit, pressing your luck. My pipe games, like a night train. Top speed through your wound piece. Rated X to say the least.
He up the pussy fast,
give it up fast.
Quick, not slow, not going to the tell if it ain't a free show. Yo, so you know, more things I'm in this shit. You be seeing, niggas rapping, they say, give it up fast. Quick and not slow, not going to the tables if it's not about flow. So you know, more people running this shit. You be sitting, niggas repping,
and that's how I go. And that's it, nigga. Word up. You know what I'm saying? Don't go. Rapanoid, Rapanoid, Nas, Havoc. To the exit, niggas, we out. What up?
These rounds of layoffs or you know, just ballooning project costs, or it does take however many tens of millions of dollars and 1,000 people on something, like,
the mom picked me up in the truck. Jerry Chunky like, fuck, I ain't scared to get stuck. So what's the deal, Poppy? You're in the feds, almost got me. I had the Cuban posse all up in my room and lobby. Negotiating like Illuminati network. We catch a body experts in retrospect to the foul connect when I lost. But that then was my fault. Now it's down the floors. Eye for an eye, what's mine is yours. I need a suite with the flowers, complimentary at Trump Tower. Sit at the table, we can build for hours. I'm getting rich as a bitch taking clips.
So there's also a lot of conversation about crunch these days and the health of teams and what these human beings have to go through to make these incredible, you know, 100 plus hour experiences like you guys make. How would you classify the health of your team as human beings? How are you guys taking care of them?
Look, we've been through, again, a lot of people here have done it for a long time. So we've been through every type of crunch you can imagine. Long ago, some ones that were very, very difficult for a lot of us, you know, personally and your time and your health and things like that. And we have gotten much, much better. So now we're at the point where, hey, we can really manage it. We have enough people to move in between it. And it's why people stay here. I think each studio and industry is very different. I don't know enough about how other groups run to really judge that. I don't want to look at ourselves. The one thing I'll say is that I think every game deserves some amount at the very end, some amount that is healthy to leave it all in the field. Because it's important to us, it's important to our fans, and you just got to make sure that is communicated really well. And look, a lot of industries have people that work really, really hard. The difference in games, when people ask about it, that's what I tell them is, sometimes in games, a lot of R&D effort. You could say, we're just going to crunch. We're going to spend 10 to 12 hours a day, and that can end up being meaningless. Right? Well, that didn't work. And you start doing that for weeks on end, that's where it really weighs on you. So that's actually the part that, outside of the hours, that you have to manage.
So if you read the report, some of the great work that Jason Fry has done, and sort of shining a light on some of the stuff, do you read those and feel good about what Bethesda and ZeniMax are doing, or do you read that and maybe say, oh, okay, well, maybe I should take a closer look at who we are and what we're doing?
We're always looking at it here, so I don't, reading something about someone else, it doesn't change how we're doing things. I feel that we've done really well with it, but there are times where we haven't, and we try to catch ourselves very quickly on those.
Yeah. Fallout 76 is big fall game, not under your personal, but this team here at Rockville's.
There was a lot of people here involved in that, yeah.
Austin, the Austin team was it, were they the
Austin studio, the whole studio in Austin's working on it. I think they've done a really incredible job, but there's a lot of people here in Rockville and in Dallas and in Montreal.
Everybody.
That was a lot of people.
So that project certainly at launch was simply just not super well received, critically certainly. Do you have an idea of how it's going to land, or were you caught off guard by the launch of that
game?
We
knew we were going to have a lot of bumps. That's a difficult development. A lot of new systems and things that you were going to try to do. Anytime you're going to do something new like that, you know you're going to have your bumps. You know that a lot of people might say, that's not the game we want from you. But we still want to be somebody who's trying new things. And that was a very difficult development on that game to get it where it was. And we were ready for, a lot of those difficulties ended up on the screen. And we knew, hey,
spend some time just thinking, where did that get me? High, more drinking, now my head empty, so can it last a couple minutes more? Ain't a funny thing when you can't figure out the source, bear witness, while I'm checking bitches off my hit list, to try to understand the fucking message I encrypted. It's your hallucinating visions of utopia, until I figure out that the perfect world is only one. Never hold my tongue, vocalism, load a gun, and I'ma shoot somebody in the face if they're too slow to run. Mac Miller, I'm the only one, but I'm the coldest one. This is pandemonium.
Got my middle finger up with a cup in the dust. Pull a hand on my nuts when I'm wildin' out in public. Welcome to America. Motherfucker, welcome to America. Yeah. My middle finger up with a cup in the dust. Pull a hand on my nuts while I'm wildin' out in public. Welcome to America. Motherfucker, welcome to America.
Yo, chick, live in Pittsburgh, bet I still her. Said I'm a wig and Mac Miller, coming up in a world for the killers. I be shaded up at the villa with a girl that know what the deal is. Yeah, they know I come from the illest. City on the map, we don't know how to act. Realest young rag go-getters in America. Bad chicks get tossed around like the merry-go. CV and Mac Mizzy taking off on PJs. We the future, so every night is a new day. Sitting in the studio chain on that Manhattan. Young visionaries and we selling out the rap show. I can trigger the wave in my sleep name paved. I feel like I am engraved on the beat. I wake up, shower, get paid, and repeat. Spit one flow and got made on the streets. Welcome to the land where you never stay for free. Swag worth a meal, drop cash with a deal veteran.
Got my middle finger up with a cup in the dust. Pull a hand on my nuts when I'm wildin' out in public. Welcome to America. Motherfucker, welcome to America. Yeah. My middle finger up with a cup in the dust. Pull a hand on my nuts while I'm wildin' out in public. Welcome to America. Motherfucker, welcome to America. Yeah.
Drop high
hot shit. Running out of patience, niggas not sick. Rolling up the dank, it's loud. Playing your one Mach 6. Rise to the top and top exchange the Glocks in the stock exchange. I watch the price of life on the block drop insane. You can't stop, it's rain, don't name drop in vain. Inhale toxic flames from tropic strains. It's aqua strain. Last week he was nothing, boxes stained. Everybody love him, chicks off the top of fame. To the top I aim, test the water so I bend the flow. No deal, but flow so real, keeping in the scopes. Sun got shine, now they say he's shady, but he never tripping though. Still facing L's, you would think a nigga wins was slow. What you think I managed for? Won't stop to the nigga who invented open the flow. Won't be hard about dropping prison soap. Begging for forgiveness, but it's business though. On records spitting Guinness flows. Gathered up resources, now you in the store.
Path is limitless, death, well, that's ridiculous. I'ma live forever, cause a legend never die. See the world is simple, but complex in the design. I spent some time just thinking, where did that get me? High, more drinking, now my head empty. So can it last a couple minutes more? Pain a funny thing when you can't figure out the source. Bear witness, while I'm checking bitches off my hit list. I'm trying to understand the fucking message I encrypted. Itching, hallucinating visions of utopia. Until I figure out that the perfect world, the lonely one. Never hold my tongue, vocal is a loaded gun. And I'ma shoot somebody in the face if they're too slow to run. Mac Miller, I'm the only one, but I'm the coldest one. This is pandemonium.
Got my middle finger up with a cup in the dust. I'm left hand on my nuts when I'm wildin' out in public. Welcome to America. Motherfucker, welcome to America. Yeah. My middle finger up with a cup in the dust. I'm left hands on my nuts while I'm wildin' out in public. Welcome to America. Motherfucker, welcome to America.
Yo, chick, live in Pittsburgh, but I still said I'm a wicked Mac Miller, coming up in a world for the killers. I be shaded up at the villa with a girl that know what the deal is. Yeah, they know I come from the illest city on the map, we don't know how to act. Realest young rag go-getters in America. Bad chicks get tossed around like the merry-go. CV and Mac busy taking off on PJs. We the future, so every night is a new day. Sitting in the studio chain on that my hat low. Young visionaries and we selling out the rap show. I can trigger the wave in my sleep, name paved. I feel like I am engraved on the beat. I wake up, shower, get paid, and repeat. Spit one flow and got made on the streets. Welcome to the land where you never stay for free. Swag worth a meal, drop cash for the deal.
Got my middle finger up with a cup in the dust. Split hand on my nuts when I'm wildin' out in public. Welcome to America. Motherfucker, welcome to America. Yeah. My middle finger up with a cup in the dust. Split hands on my nuts while I'm wildin' out in public. Welcome to America. Motherfucker, welcome to America.
Drop hot shit, running out of patience, niggas not sick. Rolling up the dank, it's loud, playing no one Mach 6. Rise to the top and top exchange the Glocks in the stock exchange. I watch the price of life on the block drop insane. You can't stop, it's rain, don't name drop in vain. Inhale toxic flames from tropic strains, it's aqua strain. Last week he was nothing, boxes stained. Everybody love him, and chicks off the top of fame. To the top I aim, test the water so I bend the flow. No deal, but flow so real, keeping in the scopes. Sun got shine, now they say he's shady, but he never tripping though. Still facing L's, you would think a nigga wins was slow. What you think I managed for? Won't stop to the nigga who invented open the flow. Won't be hard about dropping prison soap. Begging for forgiveness, but it's business though. On records spitting Guinness flows. Gathered up resources, now you in the store.
Path is limitless, death, well, that's ridiculous. I'ma live forever, cause a legend never die. See the world is simple, but complex in the design. I spent some time just thinking, where did that get me? High, more drinking, now my head empty. So can it last a couple minutes more? Pain a funny thing when you can't figure out the source. Bear witness, while I'm checking bitches off my hit list. I'm trying to understand the fucking message I encrypted. Itching, hallucinating visions of utopia.
begun till I figure out that the perfect world will only one. Never hold my tongue, vocal is a loaded gun, and I'ma shoot somebody in the face if they're too slow to run. Mac Miller, I'm the only one, but I'm the coldest one. This is pandemonium.
Got my middle finger up with a cup in the dust, on the hand on my nuts when I'm wildin' out in public. Welcome to America, motherfucker, welcome to America. Middle finger up with a cup and a dust split. Hands on my nuts while I'm wildin' out in public. Welcome to America. Motherfucker, welcome to America.
Live in Pittsburgh, bet I still her. Said I'm a wig and Mac Miller, coming up in a world for the killers. I be shaded up at the villa with a girl that know what the deal is. Yeah, they know I come from the illest city on the map. We don't know how to act. Realest young rag go getters in America. Bad chicks get tossed around like the merry go. CV and Mac busy taking off on PJs. We the future, so every night is a new day. Sitting in the studio chain on that my hat low. Young visionaries, and we selling out the rap show. I can trigger the wave in my sleep, name paved. I feel like I am engraved on the beat. I wake up, shower, get paid, and repeat. Spit one flow and got made on the streets. Welcome to the land where you never stay for free. Swag worth a meal, drop cash for the deal.
Got my middle finger up with a cup in the dust split. Hand on my nuts when I'm wildin' out in public. Welcome to America. Motherfucker, welcome to America. Yeah. My middle finger up with a cup in the dust split. Hands on my nuts while I'm wildin' out in public. Welcome to America. Motherfucker, welcome to America.
About to drop hot shit. Running out of patience, niggas not sick. Rolling up the dank, it's loud. Playing no one Mach 6. Rise to the top and top exchange the Glocks in the stock exchange. I watch the price of life on the block. Drop insane. You can't stop, it's rain. Don't name drop in vain. Inhale toxic flames from tropic strains. It's awkward strain. Last week he was nothing. Boxes stain. Everybody love him. And chicks off the top for fame. To the top I aim. Testing water, so I bend the flow. No deal, but flow so real. Keeping in the scopes. Sun got shine. Now they say he's shady, but he never dripping though. Still facing L's. You would think a nigga wins was slow. What you think I managed for? Won't stop to the nigga who invented. Open the flow. Won't be high about dropping prison. So begging for forgiveness, but it's business though. On record spitting Guinness flows. Got it up in sources, now you in the store.
Images, path is limitless, death well, that's ridiculous. I'ma live forever cause a legend never died. See the world is simple but complex in the design. I spent some time just thinking, where did that get me? High, more drinking, now my head empty. So can it last a couple minutes more? Pain a funny thing when you can't figure out the source. Bear witness while I'm checking bitches off my hit list. Who try to understand the fucking message I encrypted. Itching, hallucinating visions.